As human beings, we love making myths about things. And sometimes, in fact, these myths appear in a rule format. For example, you must always, you must never. If you want to be successful, it's important that. Well, public speaking is no different than any other subject, and I am here to bust some of those top common myths that we've created around what it takes to be a successful performer. I'm going to start with one of my favorites. So the first one is, there are specific gestures to convey power, confidence, and intent, and you must use these. So what you'll find is an awful lot of the myths that we're busting today are absolutes. You must always, you must never. Where does gesture come from? Gesture comes from our lived experience. It comes from our culture. It comes from our family, and it lives in our bodies. So for example, if I tell a client to make this same powerful gesture that I think is powerful, and they have never made it with their bodies before, they've never done this movement exactly, how are they going to own and inhabit that in a way that's authentic and actually feel confident when they're doing this particular gesture that I've told them they have to do to be like me? So you see what I've done there. If I'm a coach and a mentor who is trying to get their clients to be exactly like them, my clients are never going to get the hang of being me the way that I am me. And so as a coach or mentor, placing down this rule, I am ensuring that I am always the best out of me and my students. And that really is telling, I think, when it comes to where people's egos are. So, myth busted. There are many gestures that convey confidence and intent. And you can never try and do a universal gesture for that because your audience is going to be made up of many different people who interpret things in all kinds of ways. So ultimately, you need to look at your own style. Start observing your own gestures and begin to then use your own gestures more intentionally so that you're truly authentic in conveying what you feel. Also, gesture follows voice. My voice is different than yours, your voice is different than your friends, etc., and so on. So when I speak, my gestures need to really be holistic and match my tone, match the pace of my breathing, match the words I'm saying. And this is very individual to the moment and to the person. So the next myth I'm going to bust is really, these are sub-myths of that first myth. There is, you must gesture a lot to keep people excited and to let them know you're engaged, and you need to be gesturing all the time. The other one is, do not gesture when you're speaking. You must be very still so that people know you're very serious. So, I've seen this with a few Shakespeare teachers who have told their acting students to be terribly still when they're delivering the verse so that that language will really live on its own. Well, language is an embodied experience. Our gestures, again, need to come from ourselves, but they also need to come from our vocal delivery. I'm going to gesture in a way that truly expresses the tone or the tempo of my speech. So I notice that as I slow down, my gesture calms and slows down. And it's really worth having those kinds of moments in a speech. It's also worth being a person who minimally gestures, has a very expressive voice and face happening, and then uses one gesture to make an important point, and even uses an impactful lean in. These are just all examples. The main thing is that it's neither you must use a lot of gesture, nor, oh no, don't gesture because you might screw it up. No, It's about finding what fits your piece of speech, what fits the moment, what fits your body, yourself, your audience, and using that in a way that is truly congruent. So here's another one of my favorites. If you're an introvert, forget it. Only extroverts can be charismatic or impactful or interesting or dynamic to watch. Not so. What you will understand if you're an introvert is that there may be times when you really have something to say, and then you're really expressive. You're really ready to be open in front of people, and you're sharing because this is a moment when you've chosen to do that. So one way that introverts can really work themselves up to performance and enjoy it is to see it as distinct. A piece of text that you're speaking that's prepared, a piece of dialogue that you're having that's unprepared. Either way, if you gear yourself up for that moment, okay, now I'm gonna have to have this conversation. Okay, I'm going to be speaking for an hour here. You really lean into those moments to convey what's important to you and enjoy it, knowing that you can absolutely retreat afterwards. That's a secret for introverts. And extroverts, in fact, as performers, may need to build in slower pace sometimes, questions into their repertoire, and pauses that allow the people in the room to really enter their world and enter what's being said. Sometimes extroverts can be very full on. At the same time, I'm quite intense, so when I'm out there, I'm really out there. Next myth is about pace of voice. So it could be, I have to speak really quickly and I have to get my ideas out as quickly as possible because people will get bored with me. Versus the related myth, which is,
you have to speak very slowly so that people understand every word you're saying.
And in fact, take you seriously because you are a very serious person. What really needs to happen is that we vary pace to keep people's attention. And when we need to speak faster, because that's a naturally much more dynamic moment and I am genuinely getting excited, we have to improve our articulation for that speed. So articulation has to keep up with pace. You're going faster, articulate more like gangbusters. That's what you need to do in that situation. You don't have to talk slowly to be understood. So it's again about balance, just like with gesture. Now I can speak very, very quickly without gesturing, and what's that like? So we can experiment, right? What happens if I gesture and my gestures match my words? What happens if I'm really containing that energy and I'm just speaking very quickly? At the same time, whether quickly or slowly, vary your tone in terms of the music. Do you go up? Do you go down? But staying on one pace, whether it's pitch, whether it's pace of delivery, can be monotonous. The final myth is that male speakers are more impactful than female speakers. And I will leave that there as to why sometimes we may think that. I will give you some hints that may be around not only sometimes women may lack confidence when it comes to standing up in front of a group, though that certainly does not have to be gendered, but it can be, and there's particular reasons why that could be true. The other thing could be is we do have very impactful female speakers, but people don't hear their voices because of their own biases. Both men and women need help with performance and public speaking. Everybody, regardless of gender identity, feels really exposed when we get up in front of our tribe to perform. So we need to help each other with that. We need to help ourselves by getting training that allows us to develop our own style and explore our expressive range. Here's to unlocking your performance power.